Happiness is an extremely interesting topic. People, as you can imagine, people are very interested in it because they want to be happier and they want to figure out what the recipe is for happiness. My own research is mostly focused on pleasure. And I can tell you about the difference. One way to think about the difference is pleasure is short term. Pleasure is the experience you have when you put a bite of something delicious in your mouth, or you look at a beautiful painting, or somebody you love hugs you. Those rushes, those short-term rushes, call them pleasure. Happiness is more enduring. It's how you think about your life. So you could pull them apart. Like I could ask you to list all the pleasures of your day. Or I could even give you a smartphone. And the smartphone will go off randomly. And when it goes off randomly, you have to stop and write down, what are you doing and how much pleasure is it giving you? We could use this to measure how much pleasure you have in your life. Then we could study how much happiness you have in your life. And we typically do this just by asking you. So from a scale of 1 to 10, for instance, how happy are you for your whole life? And those numbers are reliable. There are country differences, so some countries are happy, some countries are sad. But there's a relationship, as you'd expect, between how you answer the question on happiness and how much pleasure you get in your life. It correlates about 50%. But that means that there are some people who whose lives are filled with pleasure, but you ask them, how happy are you? And they say, not so much. It also means that there are some people who, when you ask them about their happiness, will tell you sincerely, I am a very happy person. But then you ask them about the pleasures of their life, not so much. So there's a difference. Now, what everybody wants to know is, how do you get a happy life? And there's a lot of debate. One solution is to be born well. There's some biological heritability to happiness, so it's best to be born from happy parents. People claim that long-standing, stable relationships are good for happiness, close friendships, social connections. These seem to matter a lot more than money and houses and cars. There's some debate about this, but probably having kids on the whole may make you more happy. Having long-standing creative projects makes people happy. Things that engage them, puts them into a bigger thing. What doesn't make you so happy is the sort of short-term things like money and possessions. They may give you a short buzz of pleasure, but they won't give you long-standing happiness. Sometimes what makes you happy is medication. If you're sufficiently low in happiness, antidepressant medications will bring you up.